We're going to start by creating a model for our new feed item. This is so we can store the feed items in our database. So load up Atom and navigate to the SRC profiles project profiles API / models.py location. We're just going to use the existing imports that we have, so there's no need to add any more imports. At the bottom here, we're going to create a new model called profile feed item. We're going to inherit from models.model. So create a new class here, class profile feed item, and inherit from models.model. Add a doc string, profile status update. This is going to be a model for storing all the users' profile status updates. We're going to start by adding a field that points to the user profile that this update corresponds to. So we're going to add the call the field user underscore profile equals. We're going to use a special Django model field called the foreign key. A foreign key creates a link from this model to another model in our database. So the user profile is going to correspond to this user profile object here. So we're going to create a foreign key from our profile feed item to our user profile. So type models.foreignkey, and then in the first parameter field, we're going to create a string called user profile. On the second parameter, we're going to pass in what we want to do when the object is deleted. So because this feed item object will have a foreign key to the user profile, we need to tell Django, or we need to tell the database, what to do if the user profile object ever gets deleted. Because if it has a link to it and it gets deleted, then it needs to know what it does. So we're going to type on underscore delete equals models.cascade. So models.cascade, what that does is it sets on delete cascade. What that means is that if the user deletes their profile, then just go ahead and delete all of the profile status updates that go along with it. The next field that we're going to add is the status text. This is going to be used to store the text that the user adds to their status. Let's create a field called status underscore text equals, and this is just going to be a standard char field, character field. So type equals models.char field max length equals 255. So the char field requires a max length. You can't create a char field if you don't provide a max length. So you have to provide it on every one. 255 is the maximum character limit that's supported by the char field on most databases. Below status text, we're going to add a created on field. The created on field is going to store the date that the profile status update was created on. So type the name of the field, created underscore on equals models.date time field, and auto now add equals true. The date time field, as you probably guessed, is a field for storing dates and times. This auto now add is a parameter we can add to the date time field that basically says automatically set the time to now if we don't specify a time when we create the object. So when we create a new feed item, if we just leave this blank and we don't provide a specific created on date, then it will automatically add the current time. This is a really handy shortcut because previously, before they added this feature, I would have had to manually add the logic to set the date of the current time. All right, so that's all the fields we require for our profile feed item. Let's finish off our model by adding an str representation of the model. So that's the string representation, and that's so that Python knows how to convert our model object to a string. So you type def underscore underscore str underscore underscore open the bracket, self, close the bracket, colon. We'll put a doc string, return the model as a string, close the doc string, and we're going to return the status text. So if we ever just print this model object as a string, we'll return the status text. So type return self.status_text. Okay, so save the file. That's how you create a new model in Django. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next lesson.